because I had to go to the bathroom. There's going to be a little quiz. We have a free beer. That's really good. It's not from Czechia,
no,
but from...
One for you,
though. Oh, great. Thanks. Yeah, and it's from Germany. And we also have shots of this really strange...
Gold Strike.
It's called Gold Strike. And it's for the winners of the quiz. We're going to do a little quiz about it.
It's
it's really funny. Yeah, it's really dangerous. If you have more than one shot of Gold Strike, you will probably pass out.
Strike Gold.
It's a big strike, and you will probably not live to tell. But and we have a lot, because there's like a lot in there. It's like a really big bottle.
Yeah.
And it's really high alcohol. So we're going to do the story in two parts. And maybe you can do a little part of it in Czech. And nobody will understand that, but then we'll get a feeling of the Czech language. And then Marcia will do a bit in Dutch. And is this from like a book full of short stories?
Full of short stories, yeah.
It's Mapa Ani.
Mapa Ani, which means map of Anne. Anne is the main character of the book, and she's like almost invisible main character, because she appears only in the last of these short stories, and in all other she acting like almost like a ghost, everyone talking about her and talking to her and remember her and things like that, and she's like a shadow which passing through the whole stories, and in the last short story she finally act like a human being.
Yeah.
like a one of the characters of the, and it all fits together like a puzzle or something like that, and creates some white story
about this
Anna.
Yeah.
And I wanted to write it as a strange memory of some people who met sometime, and this memory of him remains in your brain and slowly like disappearing from you. It's like a remember of a strange love story which maybe never happened or something like that. And it's that's about the Anna. The book is generally about, I think, contemporary life, about how people live nowadays. How
is it located in your country? Or
not
specifically?
It's not necessary, but yeah, it's the many of the short stories are located in Prague, and but I think it's not important. I wanted to write something universal, maybe. So I think it could be people can understand all around Europe, maybe, to these stories. I hope so.
We'll see. Did everybody read the story already, or is it new? Is anybody read it? I did. Yes, a few people. Okay, then it's a good thing that we're going to read it again, and then we're going to talk about it. But maybe you could kick things off by doing a little bit in Czech.
Představení začíná. Začalo to velmi tělesně. Tepem srdce, spocenými dlaněmi, suchem v ústech. Sedím v hedvábí, v semiši, v drobných, pichlavých chloupcích, takovém jakoby křesílku, zvedám se mi žaludek, jakási šatna, maskérna, takové to zrcadlo, znáte to s žárovkama dokola, kecám, žárovky tu nejsou, naštěstí, jenom ne světlo. Sedím skoro po tmě, svíjím se v novotou páchnoucím obleku, v naškrobených látkách, ve vlastní kůži, v kůži vytrhnuté do ruda, v šampónem páchnoucích vlasech, v zastřižených nechtech, pečlivě vyloupnutých z kožné blanky, která je pořád dokola porůstá. Proč tělo pořád něčím porůstá? Pořád o něco pečovat, to by jeden zešílel, pořád něco krmit, dávat spát, omývat, pěstit, Kriste Pane, tělo je jak malé dítě, strašně nesamostatná věc. 3 minuty, 25 vteřin, už to začíná.
You have a really great read for it. Is there anybody here who understands Czech?